Thank you. Thank you. Hello, everybody. Thank you so much for being here today. I'm very, very excited to be performing these pieces for you. The first piece that was on the program was Concerto for Tuba by Gary D. Zeek. And as you heard, there's a lot of different emotions that it touches on, and a lot of different colors of sound, which is today's program theme, if you didn't notice. The first movement in that was Soaring, which was very free-sounding. The second one, Romance, which was very pretty. I like that one. And then the third one, Riot, which was very exciting. Very exciting is the word I give that. But this next piece is by Bruce Broughton. It's called Sonata for Tuba. This one does the same thing. It has three movements that all touch on very different styles of music. The first one being very articulate, the second one being very expressive, and the third one being very technical. So please enjoy Bruce Broughton's Sonata for Tuba. Thank you.
Thank you.
The next piece I'm extremely excited about. Before I start playing it, I want to say a few thank yous, because this piece is quite long and it will finish the recital. So first, I would like to say a big, big thank you to Dr. Svoboda for her constant support, and she's the reason I am the musician that I am today. When I came into the studio, I distinctly remember hearing the Zeke my first year and thinking, wow, I wish I could be that good. And here I am playing it, so that's super duper exciting, and thank you so much, Dr. Svoboda, for all the work you put into me and the development I've had because of you. So I also want to give a huge thank you to my family and all my friends who are here and on the live stream. So thank you all for being here, and thank you for your support. I wouldn't be able to do this without your support. So thank you so much. Thank you so much. Now, this last piece I commissioned about a year ago, and I had the idea about a year ago. So I was at a conference at ITEA, an ITEA conference, which is the International Tube Euphonium Association, and I saw a presentation about synesthesia. And if you don't know what synesthesia is, it's where you see colors in association to pitches, kind of like perfect pitch, but you have a color vision associated with the notes. This piece, I saw this presentation where a man played the tuba and had synesthesia representing the notes he was playing, and I had this idea to have musical themes represented by different colors rather than just musical notes. So I went to my buddy Ej Devonzo, who writes story pieces. He has a history of writing pieces that are linear stories. We talked for about 3 months on a story that we both could connect to, which we settled on a fantasy story about magic, starring the lead character Edric, who is the name of the piece, Edric's Quest. And in this story, he goes through a whole adventure. He goes on some fights, he explores magic, he has to go through the wilderness, and it's all notated in the music, and it's very detailed. But for you, I would like you to interpret what you're hearing in terms of the musical themes and try to picture what Edric is doing in his quest. There is a visual component to this, which will incorporate some flash of light, so if you have any sensitivity to that, please use your own discretion accordingly. But the visual component is going to have different colors flashing when the musical themes happen in the music. So see if you can follow along and hear how those themes change throughout the piece. I'm super excited for this, and I hope you enjoy. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.